What's up, YouTube? Phillysupermoto here. Took the day off. Expecting to do a lot today. Was not expecting to test drive a Ducati Hypermotard. Super excited. Let's get going. So it's in touring mode, but I'm not really too concerned about that. Fuel, I have no clue. I'm just excited. Oh. Let's get going, man. So we're not really too concerned about the miles, it's a demo. I was like, alright. This is the first time I rented a Ducati, it's so awesome. I've been a quarter of a mile, and I can't stop gritting. Oh my lord. She's got some pep, man. Got a gear indicator here. Mind you, we're in touring right now. So if this is a long-term review or any sort of in-depth review, this is not the video for you, man. This is first impression of a Ducati, 2017 Ducati Hypermotard, like 939 or something. Something just fucking crazy, dude. I'll tell you what, the seat, it's pretty wide. It's much wider than my KTM. As to be expected, that's just a straight dirt bike. Let's see what else. It stands pretty high. Much higher, I would almost say, than my KTM. I actually have no clue where I'm going, but that's okay. I'll go wherever the road fucking takes me on this thing. I'm not sure what sport. Fuck. Where's the fucking enter button? Oh, now we're in sport. It's cool. You got your, I think you got dual front disc Brembos in the front. Oh, massive amounts of power. I don't know. I don't have any specs. Wasn't really planning on riding in a Hypermotard today. Holy shit. Dude, as soon as we get on 309, I'll open her up a little bit for you guys. And see what you can do at like highway speeds. Dude, you gotta be careful with that fucking throttle. This thing is, I would love to fucking crash this thing just to fucking buy it. If I had fucking 12 grand, see what you got. Wow, she gets up and moves. That she does. Super smooth, man. You're still in that upright riding position, which kind of blows. Get banged around. Sixth gear, 73 miles an hour. We're doing good. Can't lose my hat though. All right, so some things I like about it, man. It's much more comfy than the Supermoto. A shit ton more power than the Supermoto. Brakes are super touchy. Like, ridiculous amount of touchy. I'm gonna get lost here because I'm so fucking excited. Alright, fucking sport mode, motards, dude, I can't even say that, man. Dude, this thing is just so fucking powerful. I don't think I even have ever ridden a bike this fucking strong before. Holy shit, I'm like a kid in a candy store. I'm gonna try to stay as focused as possible, but I'm sorry guys, it's gonna be hard to, because I'm just so fucking cheesing right now. But yeah, I'm about 6 foot, I'm tippy-toed on this. I'm gonna assume this is a stock seat height. Controls are relatively, you know, your standard, where they're at. It's a very upright riding position. It's not as upright as the Supermoto setup I got. I'm sure it'll be a little bit more comfortable on those long rides. But probably not the bike to be doing long distances on. It's probably not what it's meant for. But it's probably gonna be a hell of a lot more comfortable with the passenger. All right, let's see what we got here. Third gear, 40 miles an hour. Oh shit. Oh my lord. Yo, if you like fucking torque, this is the bike for you, man. It's got such a interesting power band. Front end feels a little weird. I'm trying to go too ham on this thing. It's not mine. I don't want to buy it, especially if it's all fucking scratched the fuck up. The handling, I think, it's going to take most people to get used to. It's the front end feels very weird, to me at least. Granted, I've been riding my Supermoto all day. Dude, that ride by wire, man, it's so precise. The throttle response is just ridiculous. I believe this is a cable clutch. It's not hydraulic as far as I'm aware. I really don't mind it though. It's buttery smooth. Yeah, the difference between the sport and the touring mode, from what I can tell, is the throttle response. So the sport's definitely laggy, a little more lag on the throttle. So isn't a bad thing, especially if you're newer to riding. What else is there? I mean, this thing probably fucking, man, fuck, dude. It just throws you in the back of the saddle, dude, at like $6,000 here. Nice little pull. Man, you were just like, you gotta be one with the bike in tune with this bitch, man. Dude, she flies, she's super comfy. If you're coming off a Supermoto, the wheels, I mean, the seats, night and day difference. There's no comparison. This is just a much more comfortable of a seat. I'm sure the gas tank is much bigger. The menu seems pretty easy to navigate. Man, that's just so smooth. I'm gonna be happy when I get out from that fucking diesel. It does sound a bit clunky. Yeah, you gotta lean forward and hold on, baby. Holy shit. The power delivery is very smooth. I feel like it's something that any, let's say, experienced rider can adapt to. It says a 939, so, I mean, this is basically a leader bike. I think this is a V-twin. The suspension's very nice. Saying this, only comparing it to my Supermoto, but it's very smooth. It's very soft and cushiony. I'm not sure if the riding modes will change that. I can definitely tell the riding modes change how the throttle response is. That's to be expected. I'm not sure about the I'm not too sure about the suspension though. But I'm sure it does. This does have ABS, also traction control. It's all right here. Has a check engine light, turn signals, low fuel. I think that's your traction control, your ABS, oil light. Hopefully that never goes on. Sounds really nice, dude. I'm not sure how the passenger would like it. I'm sorry if I can't find any twisty roads for you guys. This isn't really my fucking stomping grounds. But I'll do my best here. There's definitely a power band. I'm not too sure where it likes to grab the most. Just an overall, just really fun bike so far. Man, just tons of power. A lot of usable power too. Let's see how she is in the corners. Not even too sure what type of tires are running here, or the dimensions, but I'll try to put that in the description. Definitely feels really nice in the corners. I think I know where I'm at. Oh man, the ride-by-wire throttle, it helps you get through the corners so much more smoothly, I should say. Throttle response is so smooth. The brakes are really nice. The seat's not bad at all. I don't know how it would be on a longer trip, but I wouldn't recommend taking this bike on more than a 200-mile ride. probably the wind's just gonna beat you up, and you're not gonna put a windscreen on this thing. It'll just make it, it's just so goddamn beautiful. You know, you don't wanna put a windscreen on it. And they were nice enough to just let me walk in off the street and say, hey, is this a fucking demo? They're like, yeah, you wanna ride it? It's goddamn sunrise every morning? Of course I do. So like I said, this is just an initial first impression of the bike. Would I buy one? If I didn't already have my Supermoto, and I had a little bit better of a job, yeah, I mean, I would consider buying this. I guess some things you could compare this to is the KTM Super Duke. Is it in the same category? I don't know. Probably. Very fast, light, nimble bikes. If you guys get a chance to ride one of these, do it. I'd hate to see people, you know, spend, you know, $15,000, I think a brand new one was, on a bike that they don't even know if they're really gonna like. I mean, how do you not like a fucking, how do you not like that? You gotta be fucking the goddamn Crypt Keeper or a fucking weirdo if you're not gonna fucking, if this bike don't put a fucking smile on your face, I don't know what the fuck will. I don't care whose titties are in your face. There is some clatter, chatter, whatever you want to call it. I'm not sure if that's indicative of the Ducatis. I know some of their dry clutches do that. Yeah, between $6,000 and $7,000, she gets real fucking, real torquey. But, I mean, even if you're not interested in buying one, I mean, I kind of am now. I mean, if they would give me a decent trade-in on my Supermoto, but the Supermoto is just like its own little thing, you know. You can take it on and off-road. This is strictly on-road, that's for sure. I'm actually out here in outside of Philadelphia. So Montgomeryville Cycle Centers was kind enough to just, well, more or less throw me the keys and said, have fun, be back within an hour. So that's what I'm doing. But yeah, dude, it fucking, this bike will probably shine so well in the corners. It feels like it just grips so well. But like I said, my channel kind of blows, but you know, I hope this brings some more attention. I hope this was somewhat educational. People that are interested in this bike, like I said, this is a 2017. Just a demo, short little, you know, first initial impressions. It's a fun bike, man. What else can I say? Go out and fucking buy one. Stop talking about it. I mean, if you're not dead set on a color, or if it doesn't have to be brand new, you can save, you know, a couple thousand. I think this was like $2,000 cheaper than the new one as a demo. But anyway, you want to buy something straight out the showroom and ready to go, this might be a good fucking choice. Honestly, it's not a bad choice at all. What else can I say, dude? The seat's comfy. It's tons more power than 9 out of 10 riders needs. I would love to hear what this would sound like with like an Akrapovich or some sort of, you know, aftermarket exhaust. Probably get so fucking throaty. Oh man. But you know what? It sounds good just stock too, you know? Like I said, I'm gonna have to cut it short because I'm back here at the motorcycle shop. But I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I gave some, you know, some sort of outlook on this bike, some sort of informative information. Go ride one, man. Ooh. Go ride one. It takes fucking potholes wonderfully. But yeah, now I'm back, so I'm gonna cut it short, and I'll see you guys out there on the streets, man. See ya.